This is a pre-built version of the application. So let's start by creating the database. And next, let's go ahead and run the application. So this data is coming from the database. And we have three departments. So this one have those instructors associated with it, and it offers those courses. And this one, same thing, and this one. And we have those courses, and this course have two sessions, so we will have two classes in the system, and the other ones only have one session, so one class. And this is the max number of students for each one of the courses, and those are the qualified instructors to teach each one of those, and the prerequisites. So this course have no prerequisites. This one have this prerequisite, this one no prerequisite, and this one have those prerequisites, etc. And we have three rooms, and this is the max seating capacity for each one of those rooms, and seven instructors in the system. And this is the availability for each one of those instructors. So this one is not available on meeting time one for scheduling. And those are the qualifications. What each instructor can teach, what courses he can teach. And those are the available meeting times. So we have Monday, Wednesday, Friday from 8 to 9, 9 to 10, and 10 to 11. And Tuesday, Thursday from 8 to 9:30, and 9:30 to 11, and 11 to 12:30. And those are the students that are in the system. So 50 students in total. And this is the status of each student. So if he or she is full-time or part-time. So this one is part-time, and same for this one. And those are the courses that they already passed. So this student already passed those two courses, and he is available for all meeting times. And let's go ahead and find the fittest schedule. And in order to do that, let's run in verbose mode. So we found a solution after 170 generations. And this is the solution. So here we can see two classes of this course. So in this class is in room 2, and this one is in room 1. And they're taught by different instructors, and they are on different meeting times. So we started with 9 courses that are in the system. So here we can see 9 courses, and since this course have 2 sessions, we ended up with 10 classes. And those are the students for each one of those classes scheduled. So if we take a look at those 2 classes, so the same course, we can see that the students that are scheduled in the first class are not scheduled in the second one, since they cannot be in both classes of the same course, in both sessions of the same course. And so the max number of students for this course is 20, and we have here students, and after we finished scheduling those 20 students, we scheduled the rest in the next session of the same course. And let's go ahead and display from the class scheduled perspective. So here we go. It's essentially the same as the solution we found. So here we have when we were running. So generation 170. So this schedule has 0 conflict. And this is a table representation of that schedule. And let me do one thing. Let's go up here and take a look at the conflict. Different conflicts. So here we have a room booking conflict. So those 2 classes have the same room at the same meeting time. So where room 2 is reserved for both classes at the same time. And here we have an instructor booking conflict. So we have those 2 classes with the same instructor. So where instructor 1 is scheduled to teach both classes at the same time. And here we have a number of students conflict. So where room 3 seating capacity is 25, this room, which is smaller than this course, max number of students, which is 30. And here we have a room booking conflict. So those two classes have the same room at the same meeting time. So where room 3 is reserved for both classes at same meeting time. And here we have a number of students conflict. So we have this class where room 3 seating capacity is smaller than the course max number of students. And let's go here. So student booking conflict, where this student is booked in both classes at the same meeting time. And I cannot show the students in each one of those classes, since it would take too big a space for obvious reasons. So let's come back here and see the solution from the time schedule perspective. So at this meeting time, we have those two classes scheduled, and at this one, we have those two, etc. And from the room schedule perspective, so room 1 have this class scheduled, and room 2 have those 5 classes scheduled in it at different meeting times. And room 3, same thing, have 4 classes scheduled. And let's take a look from the instructor perspective. So this instructor is scheduled to teach those two classes, and he is available in those meeting times, and this is his qualification. So this course he is qualified to teach, and same for this one. And this instructor is scheduled to teach those two classes at meeting time 5 and meeting time 2. So this instructor is not available for meeting time 1, and he is qualified for those two courses. And let's take a look from the student perspective. So we have first full-time and part-time students. Let's go back to the code for that. So part-time students, maximum class load is 3. And full-time students' maximum class load is 5. So here, part-time student cannot take more than 3 classes, cannot be scheduled for more than 3 classes. Find another part-time student. This one, and this one. And so this student, he's full-time and he's scheduled for 4 classes, and these are the courses that are passed. And this is his availabilities. And so each one of those courses that he is scheduled to take meets the prerequisite requirements. So he has already taken the those prerequisites. And this student took those four classes, and he has not passed any courses yet, and this is his availabilities. And the source code will be available for download. Also a version that includes coding and test running the application will be available for channel members.